Good evening. The state television company Western Armenia represents the most important events of these days. Today's broadcast. The message of the National Council of Western Armenia. The statement of the Artsakh National Assembly on the status of the territories of Artsakh under the control of Azerbaijan. The Day of National Minorities in Armenia will be celebrated on the first Sunday of October. Artsakh resumes search operations for casualties of war victims in directions of Varanda and Jerakan. The terrorists fired 24 times at the positions of the government forces of the de-escalation zone of Idlib, Syria. Macron and Erdogan hold negotiations for the first time in half a year. Mount Nemrut is open for tourists after snow removal. Spiritual songs in the folk tradition of Javak e-book has been published. Declaration of the Artsakh National Assembly on the status of the territories of Artsakh under the control of Azerbaijan. Attention for those who claim that Artsakh is a part of Azerbaijan. The Artsakh National Assembly has accepted a new law declaring occupied territories the territories of Artsakh currently occupied by Azerbaijan. This law finally puts an end to all the accusations and falsifications announced by the so-called Armenian associations. The Parliament of the Republic of Armenia is discussing the bill submitted by MyStep MP Rustam Bakoyan, which proposes to celebrate the Day of National Minorities in Armenia. According to Rustam Bakoyan, changes were made during the discussion of the draft in the first to second readings. We changed the last Saturday of September to the first Sunday of October. I also had discussions about this with the representatives of national minorities. We came to a common denominator that the first Sunday of October will be celebrated in Armenia as the Day of National Minorities, Rustam Bakoyan said. He mentioned that the reason for the changes of the day is that every 7 years the last Sunday of September will be September 27, while the citizens of Armenia, including the representatives of national minorities, will never be able to celebrate that day as holiday until we have a corresponding victory, Bakoyan mentioned. The Rescue Service of Artsakh restarted the search operations for the bodies of the war casualties. The search and rescue mission was halted since February 15, when Azeri authorities had banned the search operations in territories under their control. Artsakh Interior Ministry spokesperson Hunan Tadevosyan told Armen Press that their rescuers relaunched the search operations in Hadrut, Varanda and Jirakan. As a result of the search, the remains of 1,485 killed servicemen and civilians were found after the ceasefire from November 13, 2020 until today. The deputy head of the Russian Center for Reconciliation of the Warring Parties in Syria, Admiral Vyacheslav Sitnik, said that Jabhat al-Nusra militants had carried out 24 attacks on government positions in the Idlib de-escalation zone. In the de-escalation zone of Idlib, members of Jabhat al-Nusra terrorist group carried out 24 attacks on Syrian government positions, including 10 in Idlib, 10 in Latakia, 2 in Aleppo and 2 in Hama. He told RIA Novosti. Earlier, it was reported that Russian air defense systems repulsed the attack on the Khmeimim airbase in Syria. The President of France, Emmanuel Macron, will hold a video conference discussion with the President of Turkey, Recep Tayyip Erdogan, on Tuesday evening. It is mentioned that this will be the first negotiation between the two leaders in half a year. The conference is to start at 6 p.m. local time. It is not known how long it will last. The media doesn't have information about what topics will be discussed during the discussions, but it is known that the two leaders have many disagreements and often criticize each other in public. In the fall and winter of 2020, Macron announced that Paris had information that Ankara was bringing in militants from Syria to take part in the Nagorno-Karabakh war. He also threatened to impose sanctions on Turkey if it did not give up its unilateral actions against Greece and Cyprus. Mount Nemrut, 2,206 meters high, within the borders of Kahta province, Adıyaman, Western Armenia, which is included in the UNESCO World Cultural Heritage List, has opened the tourist season after the snow removal works are completed. National Park of Mount Nemrut, where a 50 meters high, 150 meter diameter moon and giant statues belonging to the Kingdom of Gomagene are located, was closed to tourism in late December 2020 due to snowfall. The Spiritual Songs in the Folk Tradition of Javak e-book by Zaven Tagakchan, head of the Aram Kocharyan Record Library, senior researcher of the Department of Folk Music, candidate of arts, was published with the financial support of the Ministry of Education, Science, Culture and Sports of the Republic of Armenia on the initiative of the Institute of Art of National Academy of Sciences of the Republic of Armenia. The Ministry of Education, Science, Culture and Sports of the Republic of Armenia reports. The work presents for the first time the musicological examination of canonical songs. The collection includes hymns, chants, song parts of the liturgy, Christmas and Resurrection, sung prayers, and poetic texts widely spread in the life of Javakh Armenians in the 20th century. The editor of the ebook is Ripsime Pikichyan, candidate of historical sciences, associate professor of the chair of culture at Yerevan State University, and the reviewer of the book is Doctor of Arts, Professor Anna Asatryan. Now we present you Hanina by Maratuk Ensemble. The full version is available on the official website of Western Armenia TV. This was all for today. Goodbye.